hurt. I said, why do you have to go so fast like that? She said, have you tried it? I said, no, I don't need to try it. No, it's a bad idea. How fast are you going on that thing? And she said, oh, it'll go. 160. 160 on a motorcycle? Come on, why? She said, you haven't tried it yet. Come on, stay around the block. You know, I'd ridden a lot, but not something like that. So I just thought, well, it's an interesting machine. Curious about the design. I'll just take it around the block. And then there was the voice. Dave.
Yeah?
You should go faster.
I should?
Yes.
A little faster?
Much faster, Dave.
I think I should go faster.
Yes, Dave, go faster. Where was it coming from? The bike itself? It was as if the bike was impatient, going less than 100. I just thought, I don't want to make it unhappy. I'll just go a little faster. I'll just feel the acceleration. I mean, maybe I'll just chug along at a slow speed in second gear and then roll the throttle on all the way and just see, you know, just run it up to the red line and feel the acceleration. I mean, how fast can it go in second gear? Really? That fast? 110 in second gear? Yeah, it's part of 12,000 RPM. Come on! Wow. So I came back and I said, this is not a good idea. This thing finds its way into my brain. She said, yeah, isn't it great? Yeah, it's like a meditative state. Anything above 130, all the other thoughts just blow out of the back of your helmet. I said, does that work? Tank is full, the switch is on, the night is warm, the cops are gone, the rocket bike is all her own, it's called a hurricane. She told me once it's quite a ride, she said that there's this place inside where if you're moving, you can't hide, safe within the rain. She wants to run away.
Dark, shining truck she thought was parked.